So, Andrew, could you walk us through how you conduct a conversation about informed consent with a patient and their family?
Right, and this is actually of paramount importance because we can never have a patient participate in a study without their clear understanding of everything they're getting into, and that whole process is called informed consent, that they're making an informed decision on their own, understanding all the risks and benefits we've talked about of participating in a study. So there's the verbal conversation that goes along with that, but there is actually a written document. Sometimes it's 20 plus pages long, but it's very patient friendly and understandable. For patients who may speak a different language, sometimes we'll make sure that that consent form is provided in their native language. It's so important for them to really understand that. And if I'm seeing a patient for the first time and proposing a study that they might be eligible for, I'll give them this informed consent document and say, you shouldn't make this decision right now at this visit. Even though you seem very gung-ho to participate, I want you to take it home, read it thoroughly, have your family members read it, underline it, come up with what questions you have on the basis of reading this, and then we'll set up a follow-up visit where we can go over this in detail, answer your questions, make sure that you have an understanding of the logistics, the side effects, everything that this entails. This informed consent document is one that has been vetted thoroughly by our institutional review board to make sure we're not missing anything. And then at that subsequent follow-up visit, they'll come back with this consent form. We'll sit down, and after there's a clear understanding, I'll sign it, the patient will sign it, and then we can go from there in terms of continuing with screening the patient for eligibility and if they qualify moving forward. So I really can't emphasize enough the importance of that piece from an ethical standpoint, from an administrative and logistics standpoint. There's no way we can or should do any sort of experimental treatment without that full informed consent.
I agree. It's really a critical part of what we do, and it's, again, a team approach here that contribute to the informed consent, right? The physician-patient interaction, but often it'll be the research nurse may follow up a couple of days later to answer additional questions. And I think we also have to remember that informed consent, it isn't a once-done, forgotten-about discussion. It's part of continuation of care, because we'll come back to this as new information is learnt about the study. We'll relay that back to patients, or we'll see something that occurs in their particular setting that we'll need to adapt perhaps for others that are participating in the trial. So it's a dynamic process, and it's an ongoing process. But as you said, it's critical to research integrity and making sure we do right by patients.
You know, I mentioned before we both practice in very urban environments where there's folks from all different ethnicities, nationalities, languages, and sometimes we'll have, as I mentioned, consent forms fully translated into that person's language. In the cases where we don't have that, we'll actually, and that this might take a little bit longer, we will have that patient come in. We'll have a professional interpreter who basically will go over verbally in minute detail every aspect of that informed consent with them in their native language, just to make sure that they understand it. We're not trying to deprive anyone, regardless of how logistically challenging it may be, or if there's a language barrier or whatnot, of being able to have access to these trials.
Absolutely. Equitable access is very important, and perhaps you might think it the same, but I almost take it as a matter of pride when somebody who's not perhaps an English speaker chooses to participate in this trial, and we hope we've done a good job, you know, informing them and making sure they really understand all that the clinical trial process entails.